Bonjour Sophie, comment ça va?
En français?
Maybe, why not?
I'm very well, thank you.
I'm so glad we managed to catch up. We've known each other for so many years. I still think fondly of the very first video interview we recorded together, yeah. I believe. And now here we are in London again.
Yeah, so. I cannot believe that. So like 4 years ago, literally, and so many things happened. So.
And we won't be able probably to encapsulate everything in that very short video interview. Yeah. But of course, hopefully a follow-up one. First of all, the Innovate Finance Global Summit, they should give you a medal. Yeah. If they know, and I'm sure they do, like the journey it had been to make it today actually in London after the last few days in Hong Kong.
Yeah, absolutely. So 36 hours delay. I really barely made it to London at 11 p.m. yesterday, and also purchased some clothes on the way because, of course, holiday clothes with me only.
God. And then you're leaving to Paris as well very soon. So it's just a short period of opportunity. So you just spoke on stage. You were part of a panel.
Yeah.
Could you please tell us how that went?
Yeah, that was very interesting. So it's about a very old topic, collaboration versus competition. Of course, it has been visited and revisited again. But I think it went further than that because, of course, before it was competition, now we are much more in collaboration, and the panel has been more about showing that there needs to be still an element of competition to actually like create those new experiences, because if the end game is only fintech to collaborate with banks, we end up with a very standardized experience, and this is not where we need to go. So collaboration is very important between fintechs and banks, fintechs and challenger banks, fintechs and fintechs, etc. But an element of competition needs to remain for the benefits of the customers.
And you've got a lot of expertise actually in that field. The last few years have been again quite interesting for Fidor, which has been at the forefront of engagement banking, for lack of better words, for again the last 5+ years. Matthias is a great man as well, and he's very smart because he hires the right people. But when we're talking about fintech as well, and there's usually two models ish, right, to simplify it. One is to go direct, so B2C, for instance, maybe in your case, or B2B with commercial banking and SMEs, or go like white label, the white label route, okay? And it's always quite tricky for organizations to do both at the same time. So what's your experience actually on trying to do both at the same time?
So I think that's a very interesting question actually, because I think most of us started the B2C way. Fidor clearly the first of it, because we launched our bank back in 2007, between 2007 and 2010. We developed our own technology because we had no existing systems that could enable us to provide the experience we wanted. And basically it's back in 2013 that we have organizations that approached us to use our infrastructure. So we didn't think initially to become B2B at all, but it became, and it came naturally. What I was mentioning also in the panel today is that TransferWise is a very, very big example for me of we go full against banks and competing with them. I'm sure you remember this this ad from TransferWise where they went naked in front of Bank of England and saying, like, banks, we want to kill you. And a few years later, actually providing this B2B services to banks such as BPC to enable them to provide FX services. So I don't think it's I think a lot have started B2C. I think a lot will remain as well B2C. We have seen Ridian from Rate Setter mentioning that he wants competition, is remaining where he is. But those different models are actually quite easy to live together. On the Fidor side, the bank is keeping on growing. It has also been a lab for us to be able to test new innovation on the market. But B2B is also a very strong part of what we do. We have several organizations for which we are operating and launching banks.
Any exclusive for us today?
No, unfortunately. Okay. No exclusive, but we launched recently Van Lanschots, okay, in the Netherlands. Mm-hmm. Which is quite a big name, yes, in the market, so we are really proud of that. So we are on several markets, other markets coming up, focusing on Europe.
That's exciting. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And I know you probably spearheaded that as per your title and your responsibilities. Two months ago, I interviewed a good pal of mine and you as well, possibly, like Brett King, who doesn't know him. And he was talking about a competitive, like moving, right? And he was saying that it's challenging for investors, usually in terms of exit strategy or potentially banks, to deal with such an entity which goes both ways, right? And at the same time, Brett was keen to resuscitate or resurrect the brand and go full speed, like B2C again, and create the brand and work on it. In a context where there's quite a few issues recently, PR-wise, compliance-wise, from the likes of the very big ones, do you think that impacted the ability for neobanks to build that credibility and drive that awareness, hence the number of clients in their domestic markets or all over Europe in that instance? It's a long question. So do you think that, again, the PR and compliance elements that they're facing at the moment from the big ones, did that impact the ability of neobanks to build the credibility and a customer base and B2C?
No, I don't think so. I think like what has been the most difficult is about spreading the news about what they do, because they don't have the same budget as large banks. And we are now reaching a point where in the UK, a lot of people talk about Monzo or Sterling and are using them. But it took a long time. I mean, like nobody knew about it. And it's not as if those companies have like the tens of millions that banks can launch. So I think it's mostly about getting the word out in the market, rather than anything else.
Okay, and last question, because you have to go.
Yeah.
What is the key challenge or what are the key challenges for growth now for Fidor? What's next and what's the most challenging bit? In the next few months?
I would talk maybe about the B2B side. The most challenging is definitely when we sign a new client to be able to bring up the resources onto the projects, because as a multi-project and operating different systems at the same time, we need to kind of forecast and also to bring people fast on board. So we are working with different partners to be able to do that, but fast growth is definitely a challenge.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for your time, Sophie. Merci beaucoup. Ça m'a fait très plaisir de passer un peu de temps avec toi et j'espère qu'on se reverra très bientôt à Londres ou à Bordeaux.
Merci pour l'invitation, Christophe.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Merci.